You see this here, man? Y'all leave him the hell alone. Stop following him. Because they don't know I do something to him. I do some ready.
I believe it. I believe it. I believe it. Look at you. I feel protected. Extra me. Come on. Ghetto USA on the block. Kids playing, hearing gunshots.
Never fazed by the crimes that they witness. Follow me and come and see how I got this. This is Jerzee Monet, and you're watching Thisis50.com.
You know. Like an angel in the sky. I only walk in the dirt, but my steps are guided. And no matter how dark my path. So how you been doing, Jerzee Monet?
I'm here.
Cool, cool. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah, so explain this poncho thing right here, man. Well, I ain't seen a poncho in a minute.
Yeah?
Yes. It's been a long time. Shouldn't have left you.
Yeah. It's been a long time. Shouldn't have left you. Without a dope beat. Step two. Well, this is what we call... I'm going to say a frock.
What do you have under that? What's going on? Because it's spreading out pretty wide.
It's, I have a cami and some shorts.
Let me see that cami and them shorts, girl.
You know, I have
oh,
a cami shirt, pom-pom shorts.
Look at that. Let me see the pom-pom. Show them the pom-pom shorts and shit.
You want to see the pom-pom
shorts? Can they see the pom-pom shorts?
I don't know.
Show these niggas the pom-pom
show
shorts.
Pom-pom shorts.
Yes, from the side. Show them a look.
From the side.
Look at that.
The side
damn,
version.
They're going up there pretty high.
Yeah.
I see coochie hair.
Well, no, you didn't.
I saw one hair.
I nared today.
You nared?
I nared.
Oh, okay. All right,
so
now.
So that's going to be impossible.
Okay, let me see.
You're nasty and I love it.
Hey. I'm never going to change, baby. You know about me. Your hands are so wet.
Yes. Right. It's just the lotion.
Okay, I like that.
We'll give you some.
Give me some lotion, girl. Moisturize my ass.
A little ish.
That feel good, man. Get Michael Jackson.
Yeah. Is that Michael?
That's Michael.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah, put some on Mike's face. You had a situation a long time ago with DMX. How do you meet DMX, man?
Well, I was in Virginia cooking.
You owned a restaurant?
Not actually.
Okay.
I was the chef.
The plot thickens.
So, like I was saying, you know, I was cooking some Alaskan flounder. That's what I was cooking.
That sounds good.
It was excellent. So I'm cooking. He comes in the restaurant and was like, yo, what's that? I was like, Alaskan flounder. He was like, can you cook me that? I was like, yeah. So, you know, I start cooking. And I was like, you know, I know you probably hear this all the time. Looking for some new artists. He's like, I'm always looking for artists. So I was like, all right, cool. Give me some contact information. So he gave me a little number to the hotel they were staying in, which was at the Days Inn or whatever.
Smart move, DMX.
Yes, it was very smart.
Yes, sir. Did he?
Exactly.
Okay.
So I went home.
Okay, this is getting good.
Yes, it gets good. It gets
okay,
good.
Dog gets, life.
Yeah. So I go home, you know, get changed, change it up, come back, goes over to the hotel, bumps into the security guard inside of the elevator. I was like, yo, what room is X in? He's like, yo, you think I'm gonna just tell you what room X is in because you X? I'm like, yo, it's not no groupie thing here. You know what I'm saying? I'm shorty from the restaurant. So he was like, oh yeah, shorty from the restaurant. Yeah,
okay, exactly. I got you. The best way to a man's heart is through his stomach.
Exactly.
Aha, okay, I got it. So that means he really enjoyed the Alaskan flounder.
Exactly.
Okay.
Okay. Mm. I'm a keeper, not a sweeper.
Okay, all right, man. I see what you're doing right now.
All right, now.
Cleaning up.
Yeah. So, you know, the security guard came in and was like, you know, blah, 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 shorty for the restaurant.
Was like, DMX was getting to the room.
Exactly.
Okay.
We wasn't in the room yet. He was with another groupie.
Ah, damn.
I believe that this was the chick that was supposed to be Eve's best friend or something at the time.
And I don't remember this piece of gossip. Who would be Eve's best friend?
Some chick that he was sliding off with. And Eve and him were supposed to have a little love nest thingy going on or something like that. And it was some real, like, fucked up shit that the best friend had slid off behind her back. It was fucking with this nigga. And I just happened to be just coming up in the elevator when they were just coming out the room, which was beautiful because it wasn't my business. He comes off the elevator. Then I bump into Mike. I believe that was his name, Mike, right? That was his bodyguard, or Mark, that was his name, was in the room. He's like, oh, give me a minute, let me get dressed. So at that time, I ran downstairs, and I went to go get a demo tape. So I just happened to be outside and just singing, and...
You just was singing?
Just singing.
Because that's what you do.
That's just what I do.
That's who you are.
That's what I am.
Okay.
just singing, and they was like, oh, you can sing. I was like, yeah, and I just kept, you know, rocking and rocking and rocking and rocking, came back.
You was singing for real, too.
For real.
Outside. Is there any particular reason why you was doing it? Or you just be going outside and you just be singing? It can happen at any time.
Anytime I feel it, I just want to sing, I'm just going to sing.
I understand.
I don't think it's anything wrong with that.
Not at all. I love your smile.
Thank you.
Go ahead, girl.
So, I started singing. I got a lot of numbers, like about 20 cards, something like that. I went to Mark's room, back to sing for Mark, and it just happened. I was with my girlie, mind you, my home girl. They gave me a ride over there. She was there with me. So I was like, girlie, get the door. She was like, no, I don't think I should answer. So the door said. I said, girlie, get the door. You never know who's at the door. Get the door. So she went and got the door. It was DMX. Well, what do you know?
Hey, who is it? Mark here? Shorty from the restaurant? I'm going to change my clothes. I'll be right back, all right? I'm going to come back and hear you sing. Let me see what you got.
So he came back. And dropped the stuff off to his room. He came and sat down. So I wrote this song called The Life and Death of a Blunt.
Life and Death of a Blunt.
Of a Blunt.
People don't even know blunts be living.
Yes, they live.
That's crazy.
Yes.
I like where it's going.
So I recited that poem.
Okay.
And when I recited it for him, he was like, you know, I heard a lot of artists, but you're the best one yet. So I took his information, then he invited me to come back the next day to the concert. I have to always be backstage. I knew then, at that moment, I had to be a star. So I knew at that point that I wanted to do music. So I just took everything I had, went to New York. So I never left New York. Kept my house in Virginia and just stayed there.
It settled in. How do we get to the music?
We recorded 6 joints before we even went to shop for deals. Well, Love and War was my second song that I recorded.
Everybody out there. You ever wonder sometimes, how can you have love with war and war with love? But we don't even realize that they both need each other just to be above. Because if you love something, you're willing to war for it. And if you warred over it, you must have loved it first.
Like when you play the album and stuff, to me, I feel like it's a story being told all the way from the beginning to the end.
And then, like, what happens after that?
What happened was I got pregnant in the midst of my career. So that's what put a stop to the flow for a minute. So it came down to basically an ultimatum, baby or career.
And you wanted that baby that much?
No, it wasn't the option of that. That is like, to go into that is like a really, really, really deep life story. Mm-hmm. And to me, like I said to like everybody in the world, for them to understand me as a person, because I'm very, very, very spiritually inclined, that was a decision between myself and Allah, that I just didn't feel that it was conducive for me to make that decision. That was life. This is wealth. I chose life over wealth.
And so where are you right now?
Well, now I'm a mother. You know, I really got down on myself. I really did. I really lost a lot of my self-worth as far as like my own, what's the word I'm looking for? Encouragement, you know, to say that you are better than what the critics say. You know, I lost a lot of faith in myself. And I had to regain that back, like to say that, you know, this is the decision that you just made. This is not what you are. This doesn't stop you from doing music, you know? And it was like a fear, like, oh, I'm too old. I'm never gonna make it. Oh, I shouldn't even do it. It's over for me. Now I got kids, I'm a mother, da, 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 da. So it was just every excuse but the right excuse. And then I finally just said, you know what? No more excuses, just results. If you're gonna do it, do it. I do not wanna be the person that gets up in age and say, I regret this, you know? I don't. So that's when I finally decided, you know, I need to get back into this music. I did feel like a failure at one point, you know, but then I realized that to fail is just failing myself. I have to prove nothing to anybody but myself. I still think I'm very talented. I don't think I look old.
No, I don't think you look old at all. And so where can the people find you at, to, you know what I'm saying, book you on shows or see you sing?
At Jerzee Monet.
Okay.
My email is Jerzee Monet, 69. 69. And that is my birthday. Stop it. Everybody always say that. They be like, 69, you nasty.
You are so nasty.
At times I am, but that's not what that means.
Well, if you ever get it upon your heart to let me hit it, I would love the 69 with you on June 9th or whatever. No, I'm talking about that name. And like I always say, you just can't say you're real or something. You got to be Jerzee Monet. Make sure you check her out. We over when we out of here. Hey, do I have something in mind? Y'all go to commercial. And don't kiss them hoes in the mouth unless you have to.